VLOOKUP in Excel can be confusing. Unless you let AI do all the hard work for you. No syntax, no formulas, just plain English. Let's dive in. Here I am in Microsoft Excel. I have one table of data with cookie orders, and over on the side, I have another table with all the different cookie prices. I want to bring all of these different cookie prices into this table with all of my different orders. Now, of course, I could do this manually. Here I see oatmeal raisin, and if I look over on the right-hand side in the prices, it looks like that's $3.50. Macadamia nut, $5.85. Now I could go through this entire table, and I could fill in all of these different prices. But yeah, we don't have time for that. So let's go back up to the top and let's delete all these different entries. Now, traditionally, we would use a lookup function like VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP, but that requires knowing the syntax and it can be confusing, especially if you're new to Excel. Why don't we ditch the formula and instead, let's use AI. If you have Microsoft 365, you now have access to Copilot in Excel. That's basically Microsoft's AI. To be able to use Copilot, first off, I recommend turning your data into a table. This makes it easier for the AI to understand the structure, so that way it can generate more accurate and helpful results. Click into the first table titled Cookie Orders, and then up on top, let's click on Insert. And right here, we have the option to insert a table. When I hover over, you'll also see the shortcut key is Control T. I'll click on this, and my table does have headers. I'll make sure that's checked, and then click on OK. We have our first table. Let's click over into Cookie Prices, and this time let's use that shortcut key. I'll press Control T. Here it identifies all of the data. My table has headers. Then let's click on OK. Next, if you love your data, let's give it a name. With this table selected, up on top, click on the Table Design tab. And over on the left-hand side, you'll see that the current name is Table 2. That's the equivalent of Untitled Document Number 37. So let's type in something better. I'll highlight this and let's call this Cookie Prices. Then I'll click into this table. This is called Table 1. Let's highlight that and let's give it a better name. I'll call this Cookie Orders. Next, click into the table where you would like to add another column of looked up information. I'll click into Cookie Orders because I want to pull in the price from my Cookie Prices table and I want to bring that into Cookie Orders. When I click into this table, you'll notice this colorful icon. Now, honestly, it's not just pretty. This is your shortcut to looking like a spreadsheet genius. You could click on the icon right here, or alternatively, we could go up to the Home tab up on top, and all the way over on the right-hand side, we also have a Copilot icon right here. Let's click on this one. Down below, I see a message that says, I only work with files that have autosave turned on. We need to save this file in the cloud. Now, I don't know about you, but it feels like Copilot's part of a union. It has all these different rules. Kidding aside, Copilot needs access to the spreadsheet to be able to analyze and generate insights. It can't do that on your local computer. Let's click on Turn on Auto Save, and then you can save it to either OneDrive or SharePoint. I'll save it to OneDrive. Let me give this file a name, Cookie Orders, and then click on OK. Over on the right-hand side, we can finally use Copilot. I see all of these different suggested prompts. They basically let me know how I could use Copilot, but I have something very specific in mind. Down below in this text field, you can type in a prompt. I'll simply type in, fill in all the cookie prices. Then let's send that to Copilot. Right up above, it looks like Copilot came up with a solution using the XLOOKUP function. Here we can see all of the different arguments that it feeds into this function. We can even click on Show Explanation, and this will walk us through how this function works. But I'd rather just see if it comes up with the correct result. Right down below, I can preview the results. Or one of my favorite tricks, you could hover over Insert Column, and that'll insert the data directly onto your sheet as a preview. Let's hover over this. And if I look at that, it shows oatmeal raisin at $3.50, and oatmeal raisin is $3.50. Macadamia nuts showing up as $5.85, and if I look in the prices table, it's $5.85. So it looks like this function is working accurately. Let's click on Insert Column to commit this change. Let's go over and click into cell C9. And right up above in the formula bar, we can see the function, or the XLOOKUP function. If you've never heard of XLOOKUP before, it's a newer and also a more flexible version of VLOOKUP. Now, the neat thing is, because it inserted a function into all these different cells, if I update any of the prices in my cookie prices table, that'll automatically reflect in my cookie orders table. So let's say, for example, that oatmeal raisin just got a little more expensive. Those raisins cost a lot of money. So let's say an oatmeal raisin cookie is $4. Here, I'll press enter, and if we look over in cookie orders, it automatically updates all of them, once again, because it's using a function. And just like that, we did a lookup without even touching a formula. AI did all of the heavy lifting, so your brain can focus on more important things, like deciding which cookie to buy at the Kevin Cookie Company. It's a tough choice, I know. Please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.